Dr. Doreen Grand
Pichet. Dr. Doreen is an expert in autism.
Doreen Grand Pichet.
Dr. Grand Pichet.
Dr. Doreen Grand Pichet.
Dr. Doreen Grand Pichet is a visionary in the field of autism. Now you can ask her questions on Ask Dr. Doreen. Hello, ladies. It's always my pleasure. My son is 8 years old with autism. He is now verbal with lots of articulation problems. He's very aggressive and very defiant with some sensory issues. His tantrums can last 45 minutes to an hour in school as well as with his one-on-one. When he is upset, he hits, kicks, destroys property, bites, throws things at anybody, screams, has done this even to people we don't know in public, tends to run away when mad, and the new one is that he threatens to stop breathing, so he covers his mouth and nose when really upset. And she says, which I ignore. I shouldn't assume that this is a woman. This could be a dad. They go on to say, I can't even do errands without him getting mad at something. I give myself 15 and run out. I have no sitter, no ABA. I live in New York, but insurance only offers me 45 minutes once a week in a center, never home. Contacted CARD many times, and my insurance is not accepted, and I have two kids on the spectrum. Any advice? Ignoring him, blocking the area during tantrums, using first and then method with rewards, none have worked. I have no idea what to do. Any advice, and thank you. We've got to start with the hug,
Yeah, oh, absolutely. My goodness. You have your hands full. So I'm guessing that you have Medicaid, because that it is having problems rolling out in New York. That's what I'm guessing, because any other kind of commercial insurance in New York, you would have massive coverage. The only one that isn't there quite yet is New York is having issues. They keep rolling it out and stopping it and all that sort of stuff. But we should get an update on this, because it may have now finally rolled out. And if it does roll out, obviously, and we need to be, once it rolls out, we need to be in network with Medicaid. And so if we have our Medicaid approval, then we will get on there and help you, absolutely. So that is what the problem, that's the first thing, because you really have a lot going on, and this is not something that you would be able to typically handle as a parent of two children. You have so much going on. It's, even if it was me, I couldn't handle it. So let's just put it that way. You really need a help right now. So that's the first thing. It sounds to me like you, please do write into Shannon if you can. Give us your information and we'll check and see what your insurance situation is. And we can also ask Bryce and find out when the Medicaid in New York is rolling out and what the process is there. If we're in network and all that, we help you there. But it sounds like you have three different behaviors going on. The stop breathing threat, which, by the way, he won't be able to do, so don't worry about that. Mm-hmm. The second one is the running away, which is very dangerous. And the third one is major tantrums. And so the two really big issues that we're dealing with here are the running away and the major tantrums. And like any other behavior, when you deal with a challenging behavior, the real question that you have to ask is, what is the function of the behavior? What is the child trying to communicate? It sounds like he is trying to get his way by doing these behaviors. And when I say get his way, it means like he might want an object, he might not want to do anything, like he might want to get out of a situation, he might want you to leave him alone, he might want access to a certain food or a certain activity, or he might not want any demands placed on him. So always when we do these behaviors, these challenging behaviors, it's because we want to avoid something or we want to get something. And that's really the way to think about it. You either want to avoid doing work or being in a particular setting, and you want to gain access to food and toys and things that you like, okay? Or attention. You could also be trying to get attention. And the way to handle a challenging behavior is to not let the behavior be effective. So let's say if the behavior, if I throw things when someone asks me to do something I don't want to do, we have to actually make the child do the thing so that he realizes throwing is not going to get me out of it. If I want to, let's say, gain access to something like a toy, and I hit someone, we have to make sure that the child doesn't get the toy because they need to learn that hitting someone is ineffective. So there's too many types, there's too many typographies of the tantrum behavior that are going on. Like he is, I think, biting, throwing, destroying property, kicking, et cetera, et cetera. And you say it's when he's upset. The question really becomes, what is the reason for him being upset? Because whatever the reason is, you kind of have to ignore the behaviors and motor him through whatever was causing him to be upset. The other aspect of it is that, so in other words, we have to make, if he was able to speak, what would he say? So instead of hitting and all that sort of stuff, would he say, I don't want to do this right now? Or would he say, I want that toy? What would he say? That helps you. If you figure out if he used his language appropriately, what would he say? That's the function. Now, when you know the function of the behavior, you just have to make sure that he can get that thing that he wants in a better way. He can get it without tantruming. So let's say he wants a toy, and you know that he's gonna tantrum because he wants access to that toy. What we do then as behavior analysts is we teach the child how to ask for the toy instead of hitting. And that's the really important thing. We ask the child to say, I would like a break, instead of throwing a tantrum. We teach the child how to say, can I go outside and play, instead of running away. So all of those types of things are one by one techniques where we don't allow the challenging behavior to be effective, but we teach the child another behavior that is effective, okay? So now, having said all that, can you as mom with two kids, or dad with two kids, handle this? No, it's just too much going on. I think you said he's in school, and the school really needs to kick in here. If you don't have health coverage, the school needs to be responsible for this sort of thing. He's not being aggressive or defiant. He's just aggressing and being, because that's his mode of communication. Everyone at school, what you need to do is you need to ask for an IEP, and you need to request a BCBA, a board certified behavior analyst, to come and advise everyone, the people at school. He needs to, hopefully he has a shadow at school or an aide who has been given to him by the school. If he doesn't, you need to ask for that.
She says he has a one-on-one.
Okay, great. School. So that one-on-one needs to have training and oversight by a BCBA. And the BCBA will do everything I just said. They will do a functional analysis. They'll figure out what the function is of all of these behaviors. They'll write what's called a behavior intervention plan, a BIP. And they'll tell the one-on-one how to deal with it when he has these tantrums. And then they'll also train you, and they'll teach you and help you how to do this at home. So that's what you should do. In addition, if you have any time at all, and I don't know if you do because you have two children on the spectrum and you have a million things that you're doing, I would highly recommend that you go on the website Institute for Behavior Training. And
it's iBehavioralTraining.com, and I'm sure Samantha will put it up there for you too.
Right, iBehavioralTraining.com. Go on there. There you go. Thank you, Samantha. Go on that site and go to the parent section of that site and look at the module that has to do with challenging behaviors. And on the challenging behavior module, start looking at, just start going through it. They're short modules. They're not incredibly intensive, but it will give you a really good understanding of why children have these challenging behaviors and also how to manage these challenging behaviors. So I would highly recommend that you, if you can, try to learn the ABA techniques, which you can learn off the iBehavioral Training website.
Okay, so just to recap, because there's so much information here and there's so many things on your to-do list, and I don't want you to feel overwhelmed.
Right.
But the long term is that you need some help and support. Whether we're going to, if you'll email to me, and it's s.penrod@autism-live.com, there it is on the screen. If you will email me your information, then I will connect and see where it looks like Medicaid in New York State is, to see if there's a projection of how long it will be before you're eligible for that, and then you'll get much more ABA.
And we're eligible.
And potentially be able to be with CARD, which would be a wonderful thing with both of your children. If it looks like that's far, I just want to say to you that there are grants sometimes that people are getting to be able to pay for insurance that will cover the base of the insurance to get it. So if you can't do it one way, there are other ways to do it. So I just want to put that out to you, that send to me your information and I'll get back to you, because I don't have an email for you right now. But in the interim, you can't wait. You need to start working on first school. So you want to request an IEP meeting and make sure that there's a BCBA. And at home, you're going to help yourself by doing at least one of those IBT trainings, iBehavioralTraining.com. There are trainings, they're very affordable. And I know people say affordable, and that means different things to different people. They're under $10, some of them. So I just want to put that out to you, that it's that kind of affordable. Okay, it's a lot, but just if you can focus on those three areas for right now, and that moves the dial within a couple of months, I think you'd see a big, big difference if you work on those three things. But stay in touch with us and write back to me and let me know so that we can help you, because going it alone until you get more people on your case, it's
very tough.
It feels like you're on the other side of the moon by yourself, and we don't want you to feel that way. We hold hands, right? Si se puede. We can do this, and we will help you to get through it, okay? Hey, thanks for watching Autism Live. To subscribe, click here. And if you'd like to check out some more of our videos, click here.